Yo! What's up? This is Patrick.
This is Ted.
And Ted's here today to talk to us about creating our first lake house in Microsoft Fabric and possibly getting some data in. Welcome, Ted. Before we get all the way into this, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
So my name is Ted. I'm a product manager in Microsoft Fabric team. I'm working with data engineering. So all the nice things like lake houses, Spark, and everything big data.
Ooh. So Ted, before we get into this, before we go further, why don't you give us your definition of what a lake house is?
Yeah, it's a very good question. And I think there are so many definitions. It's a basically data platform which allows you to store structured and unstructured data and then manage it, analyze it, access it using different frameworks, different tools, and basically do it in a flexible and scalable way.
All right, Ted, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do organic cute? Let's do what? Let's head over to your laptop.
When you launch Microsoft Fabric, you basically have the first landing screen, which lets you choose your experience. So let's go and choose Synapse Data Engineering Experience. Once you launch it, you basically see a screen which allows you to create multiple different items. And one of the items is Lakehouse. Before you go and select that, you need to make sure that you are creating it in a workspace which allows that item to be created. So in our case, I already have a workspace. I select that workspace, go inside of it. As you see, there are already some items created in it. Mm-hmm. But if I want to create new lakehouse, I click new, then select from the list lakehouse and enter the name, demo lakehouse free. Once I click create, the Fabric platform basically provisions in lakehouse.
That was pretty easy. Just a few clicks. I didn't have to write any code or any Python or anything to create a lakehouse. I just right-click shift, gave it a name, my lakehouse got created. Now, I was looking at your screen, and there were a few other artifacts that came with that lakehouse. Can you tell us about those artifacts,
all right? When you provision a lakehouse, in addition to that, you get a SQL endpoint.
Yep.
That's your T-SQL serving layer. So it allows you to access the data which is stored in the lakehouse directly using T-SQL queries.
As a SQL, old time SQL guy, I don't need to learn Python to access or interact with this lakehouse. I can write traditional T-SQL directly against this.
Exactly. And even more, you can actually use it as a full data warehouse. You can create views, you can set your SQL policies for access and do other stuff.
Wow. Okay. So now we got this lakehouse created. It's completely empty.
Correct.
Let's talk about possibly getting some data.
Yes. There are many ways to get data in. And as you see on my screen, there are already some of them outlined. Once you get your lakehouse and it's empty, we already propose you to get the data in four most common ways.
Okay.
We can start with one which is specific to data pipelines. Mm-hmm. So I can click on this icon or select it in other menu, get data. This creates a new pipeline. Within that pipeline, I automatically get an activity called copy tool created. That copy tool will allow me to define what's the source of the data and lakehouse as a destination. And then once the pipeline runs, it basically lands all the data in. In this example, we go and select that we want to get the data from our ADLS Gen 2. I'll click next. There might be existing solutions predefined, or I can create a new connection. Mm-hmm. So from existing ones, for example, I can pick here like Lakehouse Demo, test connection if to make sure that all of the details are working correct, click next. And then copy tool basically looks at the data in ADLS and asks whatever you want to kind of copy parent folder or select any of the folders here. So for this example, I'll choose the subfolder called orders. And there are two ways to land the data. I can land the data as a binary copy. That means it will land basically as is in a source, or I can use the proposed method of landing this data in a structured format. So it tries to understand the source data, what it contains, what kind of column it contains, and land it in a Delta format. Gotcha. For this specific one, let's do it just as files. Click next. Then we select our lakehouse as a landing one. Click next. We define at which folder we want to land it. For this particular case, again, we can land it directly into the parent folder. And then we click next. Here's basically a summary which says that we will be copying data from ADLS Gen 2 into our lakehouse. And we can click this button basically to make sure that once the pipeline is saved, it runs immediately. So we click save and run.
I didn't see you write any code there. That was amazing. Now, I can use notebooks. I can use data flows. There's lots of other ways I can get data in the lakehouse. But what if I already have a lakehouse built or a data warehouse built? I don't want to rebuild that process and do all that. Is there any way I could link or connect to those existing artifacts?
We're very excited actually with the feature which we have in the lakehouses called shortcuts.
Oh.
So that allows you to reference data which you have both internally in Fabric and also in your external accounts such as IDLS Gen 2 or even Amazon S3. We're going back to our lakehouse. We have two areas. We have files and tables, and we can reference data in both of these areas. For this particular example, let's go with tables and try to reference our Delta table, which is stored in ADLS account, and see if that table will get registered here as a table, not only as a file. Mm-hmm. So we click new shortcut. We select ADLS Gen 2. Specify our Gen 2 URL. Again, we need to provide here the details of connection. As I have them saved already, I can just click next. On the next screen, I specify what's the shortcut name, and I need to specify what's the path within my ADLS account. So I do remember that it's in the sample data and subfolder orders. As soon as I click create, there is a link created to my ADLS account. So data is not copied.
That's what I was gonna ask you.
Exactly. So it's just referenced, and the way Lakehouse sees it, it feels that the data is already in there. So we get the table registered, all the metadata gets loaded, but the whole data sits still in your ADLS account in your managed storage.
So now with that table there, I could actually join that table to a table that's in my lakehouse that I prepped with Python or whatever it is I prepped it. So now I can do inner joins and cross joins or whatever it is from data in one lakehouse with data in my lakehouse and leverage all that data in one single place.
Exactly. So from the data analysis perspective or data management perspective, you can feel that this data is within the lakehouse,
mm-hmm.
but in reality actually is just referenced and is still stored in your ADLS account.
Wow. This is amazing, Ted. Thank you so much for taking the time with us today. What do you think? You got any questions? You got any comments? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about Microsoft Fabric, take a look at the playlist. It'll be floating over my head where we talk about all the great content for Microsoft Fabric. And as always, from Adam,
Ted,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.